And we're back in part two of our video. We're catching up where we left off in the article about Bill Gaither. We will continue where we left off. Bill Gaither's disobedience to God's word here by David Cloud. So let's continue. The Bible plainly teaches that homosexuality is a grave sin. It is described in Romans 1, 26 to 28 as vile affections in verse 26, against nature, also verse 26, unseemly, verse 27, and a reprobate mind in verse 28. Any sin can be forgiven through the blood of Jesus Christ, but sin must be repented of and the sinner must be converted and regenerated so that he has a new impulse toward holiness and righteousness and a revulsion toward sin. To continue in sin and to boast that one is accepted by God. In that sin, as Marcia Stevens does, brings the true gospel of Jesus Christ into confusion. The believers in the wicked city of Corinth had committed every sort of sin before they were saved, but they had been changed. Paul warned them as follows: Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves of mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortionists shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but ye are washed, but ye are sanctified. But ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. That's on 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 to 11. Paul warned the church at Corinth that God would not tolerate their fornication. Flee fornication, every sin that man do it is without the body. But he that committed fornication sinned against his own body. 1 Corinthians 6:18. If a professing Christian commits fornication or refuses to repent, he must be disciplined. 1 Corinthians 5:11. Paul told the church at Ephesus that fornication should not be once named among you as becometh saints. In Ephesians 5:3. The Bible teaches that any sexual relationship outside of marriage is sin. Marriage is honorable in all and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge. Hebrews 13:4. In the Bible, nowhere condones marriage between people of the same sex. Amen. Bill Gaither and Mark Lowry and the entire contemporary Southern gospel crowd need to heed the solemn warning of God, of God's word. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. We are not saved by our righteousness, but we are saved unto righteousness through the power of conversion and the indwelling spirit. Amen. Paul was saying, the same thing in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 that the Lord Jesus said to Nicodemus, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. That's John 3:3. Christ did not die so that the sinner can live as he wishes and still feel that God is pleased with him. Rather, he gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a people, himself a peculiar people zealous of good works. Titus 2:14. By God's grace, any sodomite can repent and cast himself upon Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, just as any adulterer can, but he cannot continue to live in his fornication and moral perversion and perverted and pretend that all is well between him and the holy God. Amen. Hebrews 12 says that God chastens his children when they sin, and if someone can sin with the immunity, he is not a child of God. Can sin with immunity is not a child of God. For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth, and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth. If he endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the Father chasteneth not? But if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then ye are bastards and not sons. Hebrews chapter 12, verses 6 to 8. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we said that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. 1 John chapter 1, verse 5 and 6. He that said, I know him and keepeth not his commandments is a liar, and the truth is not in him. 1 John 2:4. Is it wrong for believers to condemn sinful practices in this world? Is that Phariseeism? Is it legalism? Certainly not. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. For it is a shame to speak, even to speak of those things which are done of them in secret. But all things that are approved are made manifest by the light. For whatsoever doth make manifest is light. That's Ephesians 5:11 to 13. Now let's look at the word reprove. What does reprove mean? Let's look at our Webster's 1828 dictionary, which is the closest to 1611 as we can get. Reprove, verb transitive, comes from the Latin reprobo, reimprobo, to prove, to blame, to censure. I will not reprove thee for thy sacrifices. Psalm 50, verse number 8, I will not reprove thee for thy sacrifices or thy burnt offerings that have been continually before me. To charge with fault, to the face, to chide, to reprehend, Luke 3:19. But Herod the Tetrarch, being reproved by him for Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, and for the evils which Herod had done, to blame for with off as to reprove one of laziness, to convince of a fault and make manifest, John 16:8. And when he's come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. To refute, to disprove, to excite a sense of guilt, the heart of conscience reproves us, to manifest silent disapprobation of blame or blame. The vicious cannot bear the presence of the good, whose very looks reprove them, and whose life is a severe, though silent, admonition. Now, so we see that it means to refute, to rebuke somebody, just like when we rebuke someone biblically, like we're doing right now with Bill Gaither. So, meaning to refute, right? To correct someone. Again, it continues reading here. To reprove the sinful world, sinful things of this world is the Christian's solemn spiritual obligation. Reproof shines the light of God's word upon wickedness so that the sinner can be convicted of his sin and brought to repentance and faith. The only part of Marcia Stevens's report of the evening that Gaither attempted to refute was her statement that he and his wife told her that they support her ministry. In 2006, he said that he does not endorse her or her current life and work, but that he does believe that God can and still uses his song to minister to people, right? Yeah, right. In his 2006 statement, Gaither said nothing about what Mark Lowry allegedly said to Stevens, which was that he was proud of what she is doing and that he wished the fundamentalists would find Jesus. They're going to have a lot to answer for leaving the people that Jesus died for. Marcia Stevens, New Year's Eve 2002 with Bill Gaither on www.christiangaze.com. Gross. Yeah, like that's not an oxymoron, right? Ridiculous. This statement rings true to everything we know about Lowry and his hateful stance against fundamentalists. Wow. This is ridiculous, man. Completely ridiculous. The Gaithers represent the very heart and soul of Southern gospel music today. They have held homecoming specials, which have brought together most of the well-known Southern gospel groups. These include members of the Statesmen, Blackwood Brothers, the Cathedrals, the Goodmans, the Spear Family, the Florida Boys, the Gatlin Brothers, and many others. Those who have attended these gatherings have put their stamp of approval upon the ecumenical charismatic rock music side of Southern gospel by not separating from those who are guilty of these things and by not lifting up their voices to reprove them. Wow. The Bible instructs us in Ephesians 5:11 to have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but to rather reprove them. Again, rather rebuke them, right? Rather correct them. That's what the word means, right? Expose them as well. Revelation 18:4 warns God's people to come out from among the apostasy of the last hours, that she be not partakers of her sins. Complicity with doctrine on spiritual error makes me partaker with that error. 2 John warns that even to bid Godspeed to a false teacher makes me a partaker of his evil deeds. In 2 John 11, verse 11 of 2 John. I realize this is a very hard line and one that is completely foreign to the thinking of this ecumenically crazed age, but this is what the Word of God says. I also realize that the Gaithers have produced some lovely sacred music in the past, but this is no excuse for disobedience to God's Word. Amen. When the Gaithers greet 12,000 Roman Catholics, including many priests and nuns, as brethren in Christ and minister them in music, as they did in Indianapolis in 1990, they are partakers of the evil deeds of Rome. Amen. And I found this blog called libertyadvocate.com while researching Bill Gaither, and this guy is also posting something about Bill Gaither, basically exposing him and his ecumenism, and he actually posted a little bit of the article that we are reading right now. As you can see, Bill Gaither's disobedience to God's word, he's posting a little bit from this article by David Cloud. I checked a little bit of this vlog, just a little bit, and he's pretty much exposing all of the false teachings and some of the Illuminati and stuff like that, and you know, all of this, as you can see here, Trump, Billy Graham, all this garbage. So I can't really recommend it. I didn't check too much off it. I just read a few of these shorter articles, but it seems to be pretty fine. So if you want to go and check it, you can read it for yourself. It's at libertyadvocate.com. Let me know if you like it, if it's good or not. I don't know. Again, this guy just posted a little bit about Gaither, how, You know, he had said, after watching the Gaither commercial for infomercial for God Bless the USA, I threw away my Gaither CDs. I've never been a big fan of the Gaithers, never been to one of their concerts, but I did have two of their CDs, which I already rarely listen to because most of their music is too showy. The singers are puffed up and sing to show off and not to glorify God. Amen. Saturday night, I watched some of an infomercial for God Bless the USA and was shocked when the Gaithers and friends sang Lean on Me by Bill Withers. Wow. This is not a hymn or a gospel song, but the group was swaying and singing that song as an ecumenical hymn of praise to humanity. Wow. Now, I would not have been shocked because on their CD Rock of Ages, Randy Owen sings One Big Heaven, and I always skipped over this ecumenical song. Wow. And then he puts a video of that, which I'm not going to play because I don't want to get struck by YouTube. But yeah, and he continues quoting some of the article that we just finished by David Cloud. So, interesting. Interesting. Now, if we go to Bill Gaither's Wikipedia, what does it say about him? American singer and songwriter of the Southern Gospel and contemporary Christian music. Born in Alexandria, Indiana in 1936. Wrote some of these songs, blah, blah. Songwriter, performer. Let's look at this. Entrepreneurship and influence. Gaither founded the Gaither Music Company, which includes the functions of a record company, concert booking, television production, copyright management, retail store, recording studio, and telemarketing for the Gaither organization reside. He also ran the Gaither Family Resources Retail Center, included as part of the company's Live Bait Productions and Animation Company, run by Benji Gaither, one of Bill's three children. Record labels. In the 1980s, Gaither was involved with Paragon Associates, which formed a partnership with Zondervan to buy Benson Records, which is now part of Sony BMG. Wow. Now, what's interesting about this? Zondervan is the same publisher that brought you the King James, the NIV Bible. Would be great if they brought you the King James Bible, but no. Of course, they are sellouts. Zondervan is an international Christian media and publishing company located in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Zondervan is a founding member of the Evangelical Christian Publishers Association, ECPA. They are part of the HarperCollins Christian Publishing Incorporated and have multiple imports, including Zondervan Academic, blah, blah, blah. Zondervan is the commercial rights holder for the New International Version of the Bible in America. As we read on a little bit, I'm not going to read all of this. You can read it for yourself. Here we go. The first book published was Women of the Old Testament by Abraham Kuyper in 1933. Wow, what a quinky dink. Within a few years, it developed a list of its own and began publishing Bible editions. The Berkeley version appeared in 59 and the Amplified Bible in 65. The New International Version of the New Testament was published in a partnership with the International Bible Society in 73, and the Complete NIV Bible appeared in 78. So there you go. And of course, they have recording business, Christian record business for many years with the Singspiration of Zondervan Victory labels in the 60s, 70s, and so on and so forth. So basically, this is all garbage. And if we go to industry influence, just down here, I'm not going to read all of this, back in Bill Gaither here, says Gaither's homecoming tours, which started in 91, brought together major stars of the Southern Gospel and CCM industry, sparking a revival of the genres. The tours have sold more than 1.1 million tickets across the world and have included such notable venues as the Kennedy Center and Carnegie Hall. Polestar listed the tour as selling more tickets in 2004 than Elton John, Fleetwood Mac, or Rod Stewart. Wow. Yeah, definitely sellouts. Linda Randall, the Isaacs, Russ Taft, the Hoppers, Jesse Dixon, and many more have performed on the tours. Again, this is garbage. These people are sold out and compromised. And first, John chapter 4 warns us of all of this, how we ought to have discernment and test the spirits, right? Let's read it. Let's read that part and finish with finish our video with that. 1 John chapter 4, verses 1 to 6. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Hereby know we the spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already it is in the world. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. They are of the world, therefore speak they of the world, and the world heareth them. We are of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. Friends, time is getting shorter and Jesus Christ is at the door. I believe that. We ought to continue staying strong and serving God. And as for you out there that are not saved, like I said, Christ is at the door and time is getting shorter and shorter. Give your life to Christ. Repent, ask the Lord to create a clean heart in you, and call on Jesus Christ, call on his name. Accept him as your Lord and Savior. That's the best you can do, and repent of your sins. Humble your heart in the sight of God. God is holy and just and loving, and he will forgive you of all your sins, but you have to come to him, and you have to want to be saved. Amen. And when you do, Christ promises you a new heart with new desires, and you'll want to live a life, a holy life for God. And if you're a Sodomite, you can be forgiven. Anybody can be forgiven. So don't wait. Don't hesitate. Just run to the cross. Run to the cross and ask Jesus Christ to wash you in his blood. Amen. That's the most important thing, I believe. So I hope you liked the video. Again, we exposed this Gaither guy, and there will be more videos like this. I don't know if I'm going to do any CCM stuff. If the Lord leads, maybe at some point, or some Christian artists, maybe we will see what the Lord will lead. But I appreciate all your support. I appreciate the nice comments. I appreciate your prayers. And I appreciate some of you are actually sharing this on Twitter. You are forwarding the videos, and that is a blessing. I appreciate that a lot. Keep on doing that, please. That's all that matters, that the word gets out. You know, we're doing this for Jesus. We're not doing this for views or for money, or I'm not monetizing or anything. Neither am I asking for donations. I would never do that. I'm doing this for God and for his glory. That's all that matters, is that people, you know, will hear the gospel and will give their life to God. And maybe somebody out there is into this music, and so they will repent of this, you know, repent of the their idolatry and burn these records. That's my whole goal. It's about Christ, man. That's all that matters. I'm just a guy like many of you out there that is saved and that just wants to please God and just share, you know, his word and expose all these Satanists and all these deceivers. Amen. So I appreciate your prayers, and I please ask you to continue praying for us. We will be praying for you. And if you have any prayer requests or something, feel free to share it in the comment section. If you have anything specific you would like me to pray for you, I'll gladly do it. We will gladly do it. Again, we appreciate all your support. If you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you can be notified on all my videos. Again, also, we will stream on Sunday as always. I don't know what yet, whatever the Lord will lead, if it will be another pedophilia video or it will be just, you know, some Christian documentary. I don't know yet, whatever the Lord leads, but Sunday, same time as always. Anyway, thank you guys for stopping by. Love you all. Peace out. And until next time, God bless you all.